and it is again time to get into some type of trouble with the darkest dungeon. So let's see how well or less well we succeed at doing this time. Of course, last time went surprisingly well, considering we won the first boss fight. So in that respect, would think that this time might also yield some result. So let's see about it. First of all, should most probably de-stress some of the earlier mission guys. Too many with afflictions, a couple, so then we have moderate to high stress levels with a few, so should also see about getting some of these lowered. Alright, this guy only accepts to meditate, so maybe we should rather try to get rid of the requirement. Alright, this price wise, so let's see. Let's see if that works. Then did we have anyone with the disease we would like to get rid of? Might also be a good idea, especially with the alright, that's not the worst one because it only reduces critical chances. Here we actually had quite a few. Would be nice to get rid of at least some of them. That's pretty cheap to actually treat, so let's try to. I feel healthier already. Great. So that should work well for us then. Like immediately healthier. Very good. Clearly money well spent in healthcare, as usual. Tends to be the case with this kind of things. Money well spent, you say. Ah, hello. Hello, Andalar. Great to see you. Welcome to the stream. So, now that we have the earlier slightly worn heroes, mostly even being looked at a bit, we could consider further embarkment, and or if we have enough, especially to upgrade the level of recruits. Not yet, requires also armor smithing level 2, so we should try to also upgrade that in the blacksmith, what was required for level 2. Alright, more deeds, 20, so should try and gain some more heirlooms in that respect. Otherwise, do think we can try and get together embarkment team next and see about whether we can utilize some further trinkets also. This is rather nice one as it increases the healing skills, but the plus 20 stress is kind of sharp debuff, but could still give this. give this to the healing type, so should be useful. Did we have anything else even remotely useful? Quite a few of these are for specific class only. Plus 4 dots. Do think that actually the plus 5 accuracy would be nicer, especially as that trinket has no negative properties outright. Ah, great. Hello there, Tikatron. You also, of course, get the wave. Great to see you and welcome to the stream. Doing pretty well, would say. Started a bit earlier today and actually had the possibility to now add some VIP patches for the channel, as mentioned in the tweet, as got the possibility with enough followers. So Tikatron, for example, got one. Many who have been watching the channel for a long while got one of the VIP patches, so was also nice in that respect to today be able to bestow the first ones. So that was quite nice also. So let's see if we can give anyone else any useful trinkets. Do think we had one that was only for Hellion, yes. And it only increases the skills in darkness and gives minuses to debuff and bleed resist, so it's kind of questionable. The maximum HP one is actually pretty nice. Ah yeah, quite a few bleeding increases here, so actually that seems pretty useful already, equipment-wise. Alright, let's see about embarking next. So we have next boss here, but most probably not doing that yet. Right, level 5, most probably not that one yet. Here we only have level 3, with pretty big rewards. But that is kind of also probably kill one Miller, so it has also a boss now. Alright, that was like also special mission from the event and level 5, so most probably not going there yet. Let's see if we can get rid of the siren with a bit more experienced adventurers would actually be pretty nice to see and try possibly for that. Kind of not totally balanced, but we'll see how strong the boss proper might be, as this is classified as level 1, but so was the one with the swine king, and it actually would do like 13 damage each time, so that was not really very beginner friendly. Like, yes, it's a bit, the boss fights are interestingly categorized like apprentice level 1, but the boss certainly was not apprentice level 1 winnable, so it's kind of interesting overall conceptually, that how does it classify the boss fight as only that level, and then it actually is not by far true, which was somewhat confusing in that respect. So, provision. Certainly more shovels. Funny, food should be enough. Anti-venom. Bandages. Let's take a couple of keys and see if we can utilize them for something. Sixteen torches should be enough. Right, there we go.
My lofty position wasn't always accompanied by the fear of office. And there was a time when I could walk the streets or raise a glass in the tavern without concern for molestation. Faithful as the tide, one precocious village waif made it her hobby to shadow my every errand. It was
all right, unsurprisingly, like village wife shadows you might be troublesome later. Fair enough.
I always wondered what became of the unfortunate little
waif. Let's check the map out. Interesting, like rooms are in a bit separate levels, so let's move here. Here first, because there's a separate branch we have to do, so to limit backtracking, let's go this way first. All right, and first fight. Rid of that. There we go.
No quarter.
All right, that did pretty good damage. Some damage. One damage, but it self-healed more, so kind of alright. One damage was not the most useful ever. Put some daggers there. Alright, and we actually got rid of one of them. Alright, maybe we can this time finish. No, miss. There we go. Now we only have the shaman guy here. and actually can't directly beat it with the man in arms, so let's beat some corpses out. It's always like hack the corpses out first, alright? Alright, that finishes them off. Actually pretty good fight with some heirlooms also included. Very good. And next room, please. Ah, hello! Hello, Kamu! Great to see you here. Welcome to the stream. And as you may also notice, you received a VIP badge. I just got the ability to bestow some of them the first time, so great to see you here. How has your week begun? Level. There we go. Much better. And at least we surprised them, so we get to act first, which is always nice. Alright, we couldn't even hit a snail with judgment. That was better. Then. Alright, there goes the jellyfish. Their formation is and broken. The snail, that was actually pretty rare. Strike a critical at the snail. Well, ouch. Alright. Let's heal a bit here. 7, not bad, like pretty good dice for healing. 12 again, really? Let's get rid of them then. Alright, works. And some pretty good treasure. Let's put a couple of food into them then and move here so we can do the plunging strike again. Oh, already looted, no treasure unfortunately. Yeah, pretty normal also. Have been giving a customer training now at work and also today started streaming a bit earlier, so not too bad at all, and was happy to be able to give the VIP badges, the first ones for the channel, so that was also pretty fun today. And of course looking forward to the cruising next weekend also. Ah, we got some scouting advantage even. So now we know that the boss isn't here. And there's very little actually here other than obstacle and a couple of curios, so we most probably shouldn't go that way. So let's move the other way. For once the scouting came handy at like a good time. And another fight. 2 damage only even with a critical. The snail is kind of tough, but what do you say? It has like a nice shell. So wouldn't be surprising. Alright, there goes one. 18 damage, pretty good strike already. Right, that didn't do too much damage, but some. And panic. No, dodge. Right. That was quite minimal effect, fortunately. Here we go.
These nightmarish creatures can be
felled. They switch can places and keep going. Was there? Yeah, there's a curio, the box. This room actually contain. Not much. And let's move on. Next room, please. All right, we have food, so we can just do like more food. Already looted, so no treasure. Indeed, Ragabas made it to 50 followers with a little bit of time. So that was very nice. And welcome to the stream, also, Ragabas. Yeah, Kamu, it's very nice. Of course, we also went earlier with the main group, so we were, some of us were on the cruise also earlier, but not all by far, as there was the all alternative activity also on offer. Yeah, let's see then about moving further. Alright, actually pretty good amounts of scouting. We do not yet know about the boss, so there's a room battle with treasure. No. Alright, so practically, is there even more rooms here? No, so probably move this way, then consider camping maybe, especially if we know that the boss will be in the next room. Alright, more heirlooms. And let's increase illumination level.
In radiance, may we find victory.
Do some damage. Critical healing, pretty good, like heal 8. Now we might use the breakthrough ability for some mass damage. Pretty nice with the halberd. Alright, 9 damage. Always try and shock the healer. Alright. That was kind of surprising too. Do several attacks even. Here we go, now we can do further damage. be able to get rid of this. Unless we miss. Yeah. Revenge does huge damage.
Injury and despondence.
That was kind of not the best thing ever. Oh well. Do think we can fortunately camp. And heal. Heal here. Alright. That does away the revenge ability is kind of
momentum. Push on to the
would say
end.
Mildly acidic. Surely can't have more piles of gold, so let's go with that. Not going to even touch that. Usually with the shrines you get nothing but trouble. Let's see map. So there would be another room battle. Let's camp here.
Huddled together, furtive and vulnerable. Rats in a maze.
And we actually do have the resources to do the... At least we could actually do... the 8 food is kind of risky, as we might get the hunger effect more than once. But it would also reduce stress, so let's play it with a bit risky and do the 8 food camping. And now we can use camping skills. So let's see what camping skills we can do. Bless, alright. Tactics. That seems actually like a pretty good buff. But we still have time. See what we have here available. Encourage minus 15 stress. Alright, let's encourage here. Yeah. Stress reduced. Maintain equipment. Sounds like a good idea. Then we would have still two, so... Can we reduce stress further? We can reduce at least the stress effects, so... Let's do it here, because we have most stress here. And we are done. That improved things a bit after the revenge ability was kind of acidic, so let's keep moving. And we can even see the trap. Yay, for once, disarmed. That always helps with the morale, that you actually disarm a trap. Already looted, as apparently at times quite usual. Pretty nice chat activity also today, so of course, very nice to see. So, let's see what the next room holds. Alright. At least for once they have been mostly missing, so... Helps. Usually like if your opponent misses it. Nice advantage. At least. Alright, we can cause some mass damage. Pretty good. Yeah. That does away with them. Does away also with them. Not much damage and elsewhere than intended, but it's what it is. Critical, but still only 4 damage. Please push them back also. 11 healing. Oh well. So let's try and get rid of the shaman. There we go. And then we only have the big guy still to deal with. Try to strike only at them. Hey, damage will take that. Let's try the retribution ability, whether it's much use, but there we go. Now we can do the shadow move. Get a bit of buff. Heal here. 7, pretty good. That worked well, the revenge actually. Well struck. And that worked really well. A bit of morale increase. As victories mount, also some heirloom gems. No space for extra gold piles, but not too much of an issue right now. Alright. Let's open the... And it was trapped. Surprise.
The match is struck.
It's always trapped.
A blazing star is born.
Trapped with this kind of luck. Certainly unlocked, but still trapped, so that's very nice. There's the boss. Great. And one trap in the way, so actually we can now go for the boss battle next. Indeed, we'll see how the siren is like to fight. Sounds a bit demanding. Oh, a sleepy fox. Hopefully it didn't affect your schedule too much. So, let's move for the boss battle proper. Again, we'll see how hard it is, because it's like it might actually be pretty hard or not. There should be a trap, so let's see if we can spot the trap. Yes. Good. It's always morale boost to disarm traps. We have actually succeeded at coming out with less stress than we started with, which is always worrying. The last time actually had like expedition that would end up with lower stress. It ended up very poorly very soon. The dice do not lie to you. There we go. 119 HP. That works. And now we have a problem. How much we can do here. Let's try poison darts first and see if we can do poison damage. Resist the surprise. also resisted, which is nice. Now we do not really need the breakthrough because we have only one opponent. So we just strike with the pole arm. Alright, that was really nice. So do we keep losing all the opponents to the all the characters to the siren? Looks kind of like might not be the best thing ever. Let's try and damage only the siren, but might be that we end up practically dead by our own. Right, we can do the breakthrough from here. Both dots. Oh well. Wonder if the ability is able to be cancelled in any fashion, but it's kind of, especially still the healer first, kind of makes this hard. Ah, good. So they only temporarily, at least. And we are also pretty much bleeding everyone, so let's try and use a bandage also. Shadow Fade, please. There we go.
Inspiration and improvement.
Yeah, the healer isn't very stable. And we did retribution for our own, so always pleasant. Dodge all of them. 23! That was nice. At least also our own doesn't strike very well. And we do not either. That sounded worrying, but it actually did very little. And the healer even returned, at least for, like, 5 seconds.
A singular
strike. 10, not bad. And even increased the morale, so. And we even have the healer back, so we can heal the man-at-arms for once. Always takes the healer, but it does least damage, so it's kind of... I'm unsure if this is a sound strategy for the siren, which is also going to expire very soon. Soon, hopefully. Yes, 23.
The lifeblood of any port can resume again now that the roots are safe.
Actually, that was a very good fight.
A trifling victory.
And we received also two extra trinkets, so... Let's draw these out and take the trinket. And quest completed. That was actually a very nice boss fight. Nobody went mad or died, so that would be considered pretty complete success as far as this game goes. Deeply unsure why the siren kept stealing the healer, because it could do the least. Would have been much more worried if the siren would have stolen the Hellion, because could have struck like the three remaining characters, all of them with the pole arm. So that was actually for once something that was to the advantage of the player. uncommon, but very nice to see for one. Something to the advantage of the player. Which is always, always a surprising, surprising effect if you actually get to be in less trouble than more. Right, so let's then move further on. We finish the boss fight and actually even gain some levels. Minus 25 virtue chance. Somehow not the best thing ever. Plus 2 speed, plus 5 dodge. For once a positive. Positive trait, resilient, plus 10 stress heal received. Actually, for once we got pretty high stress ratings, but also otherwise improved situation.
A finely crafted instrument of butchery and bloodshed. Yours for the taking.
Free upgrade, weapon X1. Nice. Yes, we now have one more goal fulfilled. Defeat the Siren. Defeat the Formless Flesh. Yes, that sounds very enticing a goal for the future. Alright, this is cured. Nice. Quirk removed, so now we can maybe do it a bit more easily. Let's see about the free weapon upgrade. Next. Have we ever upgraded this? Yes, but it's actually free. Free. And it's better to do higher level for free, so... Here we can't do much, so... Might be the best choice. Free upgrade. Balanced picket knives. Good. Alright, and he has succeeded going missing. Somehow not totally surprised. Someone always seems to go missing. Good. Let's see about whether we have any. We should probably upgrade at some point. Also the roster. Especially why these guys are not like available. Or is it simply that the portrait is very dark in the first place? We do even have two Houndmasters now, which is kind of surprising. Now we can also reduce stress here, so we can just put them out to drink, as the caretaker is now in the gambling hall. Good. then we shop probably as neither of these are terribly. So let's see about the trades. Let's dismiss. Dismiss these. And see what, journey elsewhere. See what else we have we need can. Of sterner stock. Let's hire the occultist.
To fight the abyss, one must know it.
Good. Greyhound racing track. Unfortunately, do not think you can build one of those. An interesting idea though, like let's start a Greyhound racing track. Hello there, Priareus. You of course get the wave. Welcome to the stream. Always great to see you. As usual. So should see about embarking again, possibly do some further equipment upgrades here. Do we still need more heirlooms? Yes, somewhat more for the second level armor smithing. So let's see about embarking. Another boss fight here. Maybe not do a boss fight currently. Here we have the Swine Prince, so we could do still another boss fight. We also have the explore the barrens and skirmish. This is actually quite tough. Level 3 medium length. What we have in the ruins, so we can do short here. And then we also have the cleanse. Complete room battles. So let's do one of these short ones with the lower level ones again to improve. This is quite high level. Here we in turn do have the Houndmaster and the Occultist. What position did they prefer? That should work. Let's go with this crew for the low level task. These have different rewards. This seems preferable, as it gets us more deeds, and we wanted to be able to do the mission to the, or do the improvement for the armor smithing. So would go this way, would say preferably. Ah, very good. Great to see you here, Priareus, of course. So hopefully this is sufficiently interesting compared to a swimming session also. So, let's provision. We do even have dog treats for the Hound Master. And the firewood, but wasn't this supposed to be? Alright, medium length. No wonder we chose. We ended up with a different one and unsure how. Alright, that looks better. We did not intend to do that mission. And we still have the... How do we always end up with the... Different one. Alright, we can do this, but not the other one. We're fine. Let's go.
The fiends must be driven back. And what better place to begin than the seat of our noble line?
Alright, not very large map. Let's do this part first, as that one, and we can go all the rooms in any direction. Extra torch. Alright. Pretty nice again. Also heirloom, so not bad loot at all. Alright, dodge. Alright, hound eats spider. That works. And hound eat spider again. Have a new trinket for the Hound Master, which is pretty nice. There we go. Another fight. Alright. X stress.
Self-preservation is powerful,
oh well.
At any cost.
All
another abomination work. Cleansed from our lands.
Pretty good damage even.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
7. That's pretty good. And helps a bit with the morale also.
Executed with impunity.
Not too bad a fight.
Be wary. Triumphant pride precipitates a dizzying fall.
Nice amount of heirlooms from the chest also. Next room, please. And a trap. Alright.
Ancient trap.
7 damage. Ouch.
Unsprung and thirsting for blood.
Let's add a bit of food. Increase illumination level.
The light, the promise of safety.
Empty room, all right. So let's then backtrack. And we already know there's another fight waiting here, so. Whatever, we can't go any other way either, so let's fight them maggots.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive. Press this
critical, alright.
Give them no
quarter. That removed the spider from the equation. At least that wasn't the hardest fight ever, fortunately. Also the treasure was kind of limited, 100 gold. So not the biggest treasure ever, but the fight was fortunately pretty easy. So move back to the room where we started, at least no extra fights on the way it seems. Then we can move further. We have food, so we can just throw it. Never checked the Iron Maiden, haven't had much good luck with those. Whether they ever filled them up with treasure would be a good question.
Trinkets and baubles, paid for in blood.
All right. Next room. Empty, so nice scouting. Complete 100% of the room battles, but we are doing it this way, so we can maybe gain a bit more treasure. Let's move around that way. And usually have bad luck, but it is what it is. Yay, we for some reason succeeded at surprising the maggot.
Confidence surges
right.
As the enemy crumbles.
Touch the spider sufficiently. Oh, miss. Ouch. 6 damage and immediately get also a disease. That went really well. Alright.
A trifling victory.
Let's put some food into them and take the heirlooms. That looks curious. Altar of Light. Not touching that after what the one altar did when you inserted a torch. Alright, very nice looking room with even the holy altar and everything. Next room, please. And another battle here on the way also. Them maggots again. Critical hound bite. Nice. One of them. And another. Good.
Success so clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light?
Let's increase illumination level and open the box. Empty. Alright. Ah yes, here we have the ever famous. Ah, and they actually opened it without even asking. The lock mechanism is trapped. Yes, I know. It always is. As complained even in the description, the lock is always trapped for some reason in that kind of a thing. Empty room. And now we have the final room battle within reach. There should be a trap there. Disarmed, great. Always a good morale boost. We still have food, so let's just do that.
Executed.
Axe blade, alright, it didn't do too much damage at least. Seven, always good. Oh, hound dodge. Pretty good dodging. Alright, that removes them so they won't be causing extra stress. Hey, ouch, let's heal. Critical healing. At least the dice were in our favor. It's always funny, like, critical at healing heals a lot. Oh. Let's try with the hound. Alright. One opponent remaining. Alright. That finishes fight and some pretty good loot.
So too will resistance.
Quest completed, but we still have one room fight locked. Did we have a key? Apparently not this time, so let's ignore the locked thing and move here so we can do the final battle. Or maybe some extra treasure. Stack of books. Unremarkable. Alright. And final fight. Heal ourselves. 11. That's not bad. And resisted bleeding, so pretty much free healing. Critical judgment. Nice. Alright. 16 damage. That was very nice. And then we still have the crossbow guy. There they go.
Remind yourself that overconfidence.
And now we can finish the quest as we have visited everything in the dungeon.
More bones return to rest. Devils remanded to their abyss.
Quite a good amount of heirlooms collected also. Actually a pretty successful quest. Some level increases also. Musical. 25 stress heal received from inspiring tune. Alright. Quite specific. The worry is plus 30% stress. That's a great. Like both gambler and skilled gambler, then the worry is 30% plus stress, really. Yeah, that's like the worst probably, like debuff in the game, you can have extra stress. Ouch. That would be good to get rid of, realistically. Let's see what type of property. We'll only gamble. Let's have them gamble then, first to remove stress. Unusual for Vestal, like, go gambling sounds very virtuous pastime, like, yeah, go gambling. So, let's see, do we have to put anyone else to reduce stress? Would be good also here, so let's see if we can put them maybe to the abbey. Praying is pretty cheap. Or meditation. Otherwise the stress situation is even mildly mildly enviable. See what quests we have available. There was a bright light there. Might be. Kill the Swine Prince. That could be tried at some point too. Apprentice. We can do now pretty easy. Easy one here, so let's again take the level one or so. This was also useful, so let's do the easier mission here also. Sixteen food should be a couple of shovels, couple of anti-venom and bandages. Fourteen torches should be more than enough. So let's go.
These salt-soaked caverns are teeming with pelagic nightmares. They must be flushed out.
Scouting bonus, nice. Kind of two-sided, so let's do... This side is much longer, so let's do the shorter side first. Free torch.
A fortune, waiting to be spent.
Disarmed. Nice. Should be a fight here. Yes. Not very good dice, like miss. Let's try shot here. All right. Ouch.
Injury. Palpable fear.
Quite an amount of damage.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
At least some of them miss. Nine. Not too bad. one. That was not the best dice ever either. And we hit the wrong target. Is a bit better. At least some health. Ouch. 11. The amount of bad dice in this fight is quite staggering. It looks exactly like how this game typically is. Alright, that removes one opponent, fortunately. Let's try to heal again. 3. They are already bleeding, so that is not really an issue. Bleeding not an issue. Use a bandage. Alright, that's an improvement. 10. Let's heal here again. 11, that's good. Miss. Wonder how the hound misses, but it does. 3. Alright, that finishes them off. Slowly getting there. Alright. Slowly getting there. Some food might be useful. Main problem is the very limited health here, but it is what it is.
The promise of safety.
Alright, next room. Next room, please. Always more torches. Empty room, so this part is concluded. So let's walk back. We have food to spare, fortunately. Keep moving. Next room. All right, 75 gold, not like the best sacks ever, not that awesome. Right, we are ready to fight. All right. fight that finishes the jellyfish off. Let's try the snail, because it takes a lot of hits and kind of resists damage. Ouch, 3 damage for snail ability. That's a lot. 12 healed, great. And even resisted bleeding, so pretty much healed for free, doesn't need bandaging. Alright, some extra stress. Great. But they also expired then. Let's try and heal self. 1. At least didn't start bleeding. Hound isn't very good at striking the snail either, but it's bleeding. Unsure how, but... And miss. At least the snail is bleeding out, which kind of helps. Critical, alright. And gave some morale increase. Again, 1 healed. That is not the best result ever. And miss. Alright, the arrow didn't miss. Alright, that finishes the fight.
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
Next room. No fight here.
Wealth beyond
heirloom. Nice.
Awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
And a fight. Surprised, so now the order is also confused, which is always a great start. As usual, try to heal self again. Alright, snipe the jellyfish at least.
Injury and despondence set the stage for heroism or cowardice.
Let's move backwards and we can't use the hound from the front row. And missed. Somehow it seems the hit dies with the bounty hunter are broken. Out
for the slightest lapse in concentration.
At least someone becomes powerful from stress.
No place for the weak or foolhardy.
Yeah.
Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
Somehow do not think we are going to win 100% of the room battles. Like yes, we can be not at the death's door. But we do not either have anyone capable of healing other than themselves anymore, because we do not have the occultist, and we still have two rooms to go, so this is pretty much impossible. Abandon.
We fall so that we may
that
learn
was
to
some
ourselves up once again.
Very limited luck. At least we get to keep the items we collected even then, which is merciful. Weak grip, very nice. Will only flagellate. Zoophobia. Oh, that sounds kind of unfortunate.
Is a great horror beneath the manor. A crawling chaos that must be destroyed.
All right, new quirk, meditator. Oh well. And we have one addition to the graveyard, which is always, always great. Yeah, oh well. At least only apprentice and not a veteran. We hired the occultist only recently, so that was the least loss. And now, did this agree to reduce stress in any way? Yes. So they shall go and drink. And gamble. So, you are reducing stress, and then also the third one. Do you think this was the one who will only flagellate? So let's do that. Always nice, like flagellate, yes. Alright, so at least we are getting those maintained and can now consider. Right, it starts to be the usual 1.5 hours, but let's see if we can still do one quest and then conclude for today. One bonus quest, let's see. What do we have here? Right, we could scout the estate. Try and kill the Sonorous Prophet. Cleanse, so medium length quest. We should also try and develop the first level fighter at some point, would be nice. We can most probably go here though with the man at arms and the healer. And the highwayman and the hellion, so should be pretty strong team. We can do on the average level 3 quest should be doable, and we have one camping there. Would be a nice a bit longer quest to finish with if, especially if it worked out well, which would be of course quite nice. So let's purchase two shovels. Let's do 20 food here, as we may want to camp once. If we consider the 8 food reserve for that, we have only 4 food extra. So let's go with that. Couple of anti-venom. 4 bandages. And 14 torches. Here we go.
Fiends must be driven back, and what better place to begin than the seat of our noble line?
Let's see about how it goes. All right, some scouting bonus, nice. Room battle with Curio, all right, and a free torch.
If only treasure could staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption.
And we can use a shovel.
Even
possibly
the cold
brought
stone
some.
Seems bent on
digging without
passage.
The shovel is kind of wearing to the team. Right, spiders. And we even surprised them, it's always nice. That should work. Dodge judgment. Alright, we do not really have very good hit dice today.
Another one falls.
This guy doesn't seem to be doing very well with spiders.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Really? Let's heal. Like, how bad luck is that? 23 only. That should be sufficient. And missed. Alright.
Be wary. Triumphant pride precipitates a
dizzying fall. Which places so can do? Let's save the food for now and heal them once in another combat. Alright, buff. That is kind of a side part, so let's do that first. And immediately walk into the trap.
Cruel machinations spring to life.
Oh well.
With a singular purpose.
Alright, that didn't really work either. Let's put some food here, so. Empty room, so keep going and immediately have the hunger. handsome reward. 1,000 gold, not bad.
For a task well performed.
And there's a trap. And triggered. Luck with traps. Somewhat limited.
And not the rule.
Empty room. Next, please. That doesn't look very promising. Five damage only. Oh well. Let's heal here. Critical healing, at least once the dies are in favor. That looks impressive. Still no hit. Alright, finally hit the with the pistol, not the greatest shooter ever. A bit dodgy like. Miss with the pistol again and again.
The abyss returns even the boldest game.
Alright, there we go.
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
Alright, and still one room to check here. Right, pretty big fight. Ten, not bad.
Press this advantage. Give them no quarter.
Tested and fearful. Nice, so they will have time to then just stop acting. At least we get to shoot still. Good. And that also improved the situation. 7, not bad. Missed. At least the corpses are easy to shoot at.
Confusion. Nerves.
Let's heal here. Let's yap at the bodies. I'm sure what it actually would do.
Confidence.
Right, that
finishes. The enemy crumbles.
Finishes. That or and we do not have enough room for Onyx, so do not totally mind. Let's see the chest and crap. Yes! That does with this part of the dungeon, so let's walk back and see if we can take the walk back without stressing out too much, because sometimes they stress from seeing the same dungeon like that. So keep walking. And hunger. As usual, we might not be left with enough food to camp, but we don't necessarily need to camp anyway. We can relieve stress in town, so. Next room, please.
Lit. The path is clear.
All right.
I require only the strength to follow it.
Next room, please. Now we get to move to the rest of the dungeon. And again, this is like the one of the more interesting things, the gold. It's very stylish looking, but unfortunately kind of not the best thing ever.
Uncertainty, the birthplace of dread.
A 13, nice. Bubbling. That helped a bit.
Grievous injury.
17. And hard. Really.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
It's quite an increase of stress. Not otherwise too bad, but the amount of stress is ridiculous. Right.
This expedition at least promises success.
Don't really care for these items. 750 gold, so certainly replace jade with emerald. Actually going to try still. Even without the third character. Let's see if we can win the rest of the room fights. Because there's a limited amount of room fights, so going to keep trying. Hopefully the gold doesn't appear too many times. None of these rooms have a room fight, so actually there will be at most two, so going to keep trying. Normal fights are of course. And yes, I'm quite unsure why I keep getting this thing. Oh well. Let's try to get rid of the cultist first, because this cultist is really killing morale. The first thing really with that paranoid crate.
The walls close in. The shadows whisper of conspiracy.
Eleven. That helps at least. Get rid of the cultist. Kaltos is really horrible in terms of the morale effect. Right, let's use a bandit here. Then do breakthrough. There we go, that helps. 12, not bad at all. Well, 11, alright, pretty good critical luck, at least. But this is quite horrible also, because of course it's horror and then you take even more damage to morale. Six. Not bad. Alright, that finishes has no intrinsic them off. Unless inordinate exsanguination. Make more space for heirlooms. So put some food into them. Emeralds we can stack, leave the onyx here. So, how far we still have to make it? We could either camp or... We actually have the food to do the 8-foot camping, so... Apparently doesn't allow us to camp in the... hallway, do think we have a shovel, so that helps. Hello, Kisu. Great to see you. You of course get the wave also. Always great to see you. Welcome to the stream. You may also notice that you now received a VIP badge to the channel as was able to give out the first ones. So. Welcome as a VIP also, Kisu. So, let's see about like how far we should push. Bookshelf, let's try. Alright, apparently a positive trait for once. And enter the room. We know this room has no room paddle, so... Let's camp here.
Circle in the dark.
And have the battle may yet be won. Camping. And reduce stress on them so they might not get a heart attack. Tactics. Didn't help terribly, like increase stress by camping. Oh well.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted.
At least we
and purpose is made clear.
Can like put some extra food here. And we have limited amount of room fights left because they are both here if there are two, so let's see if we again meet the goal. No, the collector though. Even nicer. 98 HP. Might be that we are running away at some point. Let's heal oneself. Then start hacking at it. The main problem here is whether we run out of sanity. 14. Alright. Now we can strike with the breakthrough for something. And all miss. However, great. Bandage and nope. Not bad, but it takes like 22 also for each of these, so it's
injury and despondence,
not very easy at all. Heal here.
Or cowardice.
And at least one of those is done. Not very easy. Mm-hmm. 19. That helps. 23 out. And a heart attack. At this point it's quite probable that we are
reeling, gasping,
retreating. Over the edge into like really tough opponents.
A wise general cuts losses.
And we certainly are not going to succeed, as if we look at the map, that fight is the one we certainly can't win. So, abandon here. That was tough.
Do not ruminate on this fleeting failure. The campaign is long, and victory will come.
Quite a few heirlooms, but also like need to hire more people. Yeah, this is like really nice. Gifted. All right. That's actually a bit better. That was tough. Really, really hard.
Women, hard men, mission. Soldiers and outlaws. Fools and corpses. All will find their way to us now that the road is clear.
Ah, hello, Luna. Great to see you here. You, of course, also get the wave. Just had tail handed to oneself pretty well, so let's see about doing a bit more before concluding. And also Luna, you now have the VIP badge for the channel, as was now able to give out some. Let's see about like getting rid of stress for some of these. Alright, this will only flagellate apparently, so. And it's pretty expensive. And also here should probably reduce stress. At least they will simply drink. Very good. And we have a bit more space for
the campaign can wait.
Not going
now,
here though.
Carnage calls.
But intended to check here, like quite a few people for once. Let's again get the healer.
A sister of battle, pious and unrelenting.
And another fighter. And maybe again also a shield breaker. Has been a while since I've had one. Upgrading recruit experience still requires the next level of armor smithing. Let's see if we can finally do that. Yes, so now we can next upgrade the stage codes for higher level recruits. That's good. That's actually very good. So in the future we will also have higher level recruits available from the stage codes. You're welcome, Luna. Alright, let's do one more embarkation. Should probably also sell some of the trinkets. Sell a few more things to actually have enough resources to embark. Now we have enough money to even embark, so we could do at least one further quest. And maybe not expire totally this time. The previous one was really unlucky. Might try with the low level types. Short. Explore 90% of the room. This we will be doing. Two shovels. Food. Bandages, anti-venom. And 12 torches ready to go.
Pace out the halls of your lineage once familiar. Now, Boren.
One room here, so let's check that out first. Cool and uninteresting books. Crap, alright. 6 damage, quite a bit. Empty room, so backtrack. At least the traps work only once per go, and it's not like trap again. At least something is a bit easier.
The
light, illuminate the promise of safety. Move to next room. Extra torch.
Finding the always stuff like is the least, first test.
Least interesting home. Loot, pretty much. You looted one extra torch. So, how was Luna's day? Day to day. Next room, please. Crap. Ouch.
Carelessness will find no clemency.
More damage to traps this far than opponents. Scouting ability would be nice, but it requires characters that have the scouting skills. Empty room. Next, please. So, let's see if this mission is a bit less of disaster. The previous one was like the goal again, and then the collector and trap. Ouch. A lot of damage traps this embankment. 100 gold, not very much. Empty room. Next, please. Extra torch. Good curios always. Let's find one torch.
Trinkets and baubles. Paid for in blood.
Not touching that, because know what it is. Alright, fight. Nice. Oh, dodge. Deal. Fourteen, not bad. Dodge both. Wow. Not bad either. Once the dice were in favor for a moment. And then bleed, yes. Let's hope we get to use a bandit soon. Right, and pushed all the way through. Heal. We don't stop bleeding, surprise. Kind of stuck back here. Let's also heal here. Still didn't stop the bleeding. Bandage. Impale everyone. Good. Two deaths. That's great. Let's move backwards. Fail again, strike also the corpses. Let's use the mace with the healer. Nice. And heal here. Let's move backwards with the healer. And then strike.
Formation is broken.
Nice spare striking. Good amounts of treasure and heirlooms. And then we reorganize the whole thing. There we go. Nice. Next room, please. Ah, great. Luna got pizza. A sample of my pizza. And Kisu has actually been then working some with Unity. Very nice. Yeah, we do have pretty good amount of the new VIP viewers today here even. The A-list, would say. Very nice to see you all. Has been very nice. Nice day and stream in that respect. So, let's continue the quest. More heirlooms. Nice. Another fight. Good. Missed. Right, that did some damage. Missed. That was nice that they actually... Some of them even missed. Seven. Right. Heal here a bit. And missed again. And now they probably won't miss anymore. Alright, let's try and impale. Very nice for mass damage. Alright, that evens the situation out a lot. Right, good to remove that. The horror ability was quite tough. Miss Dazzling Light, alright. Team. Nice.
Be wary. Triumphant pride precipitates a dizzying fall.
Very nice. Next room. Quite stressed, but all right. Let's hope for good dice. No fearful. Oh well, at least they will fight probably much of the time. We are not yet up to hard attack territory, so works. Missed. Are the guys again like somehow poor? Heal here. Alright, that works better. At least not all misses. Might have missed you, but will certainly hit me, don't you say? missed. Somehow the hounds haven't been very good at hitting things. Fortunately, also the spiders missed.
Another
there we go.
Cleansed
one left.
Lands.
Let's try dazzling light. Nope. And missed. Dazzling light, one damage. First time I've seen actually something killed by the dazzling light skill. Nice. Sack is empty. Next room. Another fight. Good. Missed. Seven. Not bad. Let's try and heal here a bit.
Compassion is a rarity in the fevered pitch of battle.
Missed, fortunately. That helps. Heal here. Impale. Nice. Seven. Good. We can get rid of even the crossbow guy soon. And even missed, despite the doomsaying by the character themselves. Let's try the hound. No luck. Let's try dazzling light at the corpse. Whoops, that was not intended to push the button. Let's beat up the corpses, because otherwise we can't hit the crossbow guy. Alright. That works.
Remind yourself that overconfidence
quest complete.
Is
we still have a room left, so let's continue and see what we can find in the last room. And open the heirloom chest. Great, more heirlooms.
Waiting to be spent.
Heirlooms are like really important in this game, because they are the only thing that really allows you to develop your town. We have food, so let's just deal with hunger. Won't be opening the Iron Maiden, as they are always bad luck this far. Empty room, so now we have explored the complete dungeon. Finish quest.
The shifted corridors and sloped walls of our ancestry are beginning to feel familiar.
And pretty good amount of heirlooms. 3000 gold, 3 deeds, and snake oil. Reduces stress, so it's useful, though does nothing, it apparently is better. As it does nothing, it reduces stress, so that's good. Bad healer. Fortunately, not like the worst thing ever for the Crusader. Robust. At least for once something useful. Balanced. Move resist. Alright, not bad.
Death and demise. Cause for celebration.
Bar is free, gambling hall is free. Nice, free tavern function. That's certainly among the more useful things. So let's see who we should treat for stress. Certainly here. Especially the one with the affliction, so let's make use of the free tavern slots. So there you go. And then you go gambling. All right. Alright, and here we have the caretaker. So let's keep it at that for now. Alright, so let's see about maybe do one short quest further and then conclude. Let's see if we can embark upon anything interesting. Increase the level in ruins. We can do a short quest actually at the cold, so let's see if we have pretty doable stress here. Could also try. How was the positions? Yes. Most probably if we can take like the level 4 guy also. Let's see whether that's possible. Seems so. Let's go there for the last thing today. So some more fishmen and food. Take 16 food and we are done. Empire.
These salt-soaked caverns are teeming with pelagic nightmares.
All right.
They must be flushed.
Good night, Kamu, and thanks for coming along. You of course get the wave also. Thank you for coming to see the stream and see you again soon. There we go. So even a scouting bonus, nice. Obstacle, curio and a fight. Move. Not even seeing the fish, it never means anything good. Fortunately, we brought shovels.
Another misfortune.
Yay, we surprised them. Very good. Let's use some chemical weapons. And hound. And miss. Alright. Immediately bleeding, so let's remember to use a bandage. Now we get to use the bandit first. Then let's try here. Flight also helps. Alright, that's a big critical. 13. Good for morale also. After poison, also very good. And bleeding again. The rent for old gods' ability is kind of frustrating, as you typically start to bleed all the time. There we go. And use bandage. And let's open the chest, and it's trapped. Alright, then use anti-venom. Nice. And we get scouting, which is always good. Alright, there's the one side room, and then there's no room battle there, but we can still find something here. 100 gold, not very much. Contaminated, surprise. Resist disease for once, like luck with dice, which is rare. Usually you always get the disease, it seems. Let's illuminate. We can. Try and strike. 11. Impunity. And then again use bandage. Honey. Yes. And some morale gain. Right, that finishes them off. And some treasure. So that was already useful to go also in that direction, despite the extra fight, as we gained some pretty good treasure from there. So backtrack. And move. Crap. Not able to disarm. Let's have some food. plus relief. Let's examine. Message has an impact on the hero. Negative effect. Yeah, oh well, certainly an impact. There should be a fight here, do you think? Yes. Alright, some chemical weapons. And you found. Missed. Alright. Let's get rid of one.
Destroy them all.
Also bleeding. Should have brought like 10 times more bandages, but you never know. Right, that's the way we're gonna turn. Now actually need to hack away at the corpses, or can actually also heal oneself, which is a bit better for one. Didn't stop the bleeding though, so let's heal here, that should stop the bleeding, yes. Missed. See if this removes the bleeding or just buffs. No, still bleeding. Oh well.
Gently.
Poison also helps. Now we have only one. 8 damage. Let's heal them for one. Not very lucky guys. Let's poison them. Good. They will probably expire taking a turn. Heal here again for one.
Healed, but never hidden.
Heal there again. Self-heal. Alright, also 19 damage directly there.
These nightmarish creatures
complete.
They
still have one room, so let's actually check that out also. Increase illumination. Right, that worked. Scouting bonus. So there would be a fight here. Let's keep going. Always dangerous, but we are not exactly here to play it safe. Oh, all right, Briares, hopefully you'll feel better, so we'll also give you a wave and wish you a pleasant night and hope to see you soon again in the stream. So thank you for dropping along. Let's keep going and see. More heirlooms, not bad. Craft disarmed for once. Improved morale.
Lurching composition.
Yes, always when you think. Thing from the stars. 106 HP. Yes, exactly what we think would be great to encounter. Mist. Right, at least something does damage. Mist. See if this is even doable. Fortunately, we can run away. Most probably. 11. Alright. That's a bit better. Yeah. Don't like those crystals, because typically they immediately cause a lot of trouble. Kill the crystal. Stunned. And missed.
Frailty finally claim their due.
Would be nice to get to use the anti-venom. That helps a bit.
Anger is power. Unleash it.
Heal here and then. Right, give the crystal.
Another abomination cleansed from our land.
We're not quite giving up, it's already halfway done, so. And missed. With these hit dice, this certainly isn't going to work. Courageous. Put.
A moment of valor shines brightest against the backdrop of despair.
Irrational, right? Six. Better than none, of course. Ouch. All right. Heal here and see if they are cured, yes. Two. No, not much. 21. Yes.
At the very precipice of oblivion.
Heal. Let's kill kill the crystal in the meantime so it won't explode.
Injury and despondence set the stage for heroism or cowardice.
Right, flight eat them, at least they are taking some extra damage from that.
Teetering on the brink, facing the abyss.
Let's kill the crystal. Ouch. Do a hound at them. Let's heal here. Alright, that helps a bit. Still trying. Get the crystal. Three, not much, but they do not have much left. 16. Do think we can do the 16. One. Better than zero. Heart attack, alright, but do think we can heal them. Heart attack doesn't matter because it reduces stress. Heal the crystal. Only 9 left though, so 1. Let's try and flight them. Yes, flight it, so they actually will die. Wow. 25 comet shards, moon ring, gold. That was tough. But one. Nobody died and only one heart attack. Certainly not going to push luck with the last room. Quest complete. That was nice.
The things are driven back.
Very nice fight, like. Very close. So levels increased. Prismatic isolation. Plus 25 debuff resist. Alright, not bad. Photomania. Minus 20 stress if thoughts above 75. Nice. That's actually useful because usually have kept the illumination very high. That was a nice fight.
Willful determination sweeps through the barracks.
Apparently it was not a quest monster, only very difficult and impressive looking. Alright. So, this most probably concludes today. Let's see if there's anyone online for us to raid. acid drips is doing art. Let's see what he's up to. Yeah, he's apparently drawing something a bit. Spooky fighty something there, so let's raid him. Has been a while since we have raided him. That to thank for viewing, and it was very nice gaming tonight. Probably will be streaming a different game already tomorrow, so have a good rest of the night. Good night.